Well, hello, hello. How are you, my fine friends? Ryan J here. Let's shoot a sales and marketing video, huh? All right. Today, I got a lot of acronyms coming at you. But first, listen to this. This is, oh no. I have this playing usually in the background. So whimsical and fluty, and it's like Zanfir with his pan flute. Okay. All right, enough of that. At any rate, okay, so we got some acronyms today. What I'm going to also share with you are some post ideas that you can use on social media. So if you find yourself like, oh my gosh, I should post today. I don't know what to post. My brain melted out of my ears. I don't know. Well, you know what? It's the holiday season, so you can use the holiday season. Everybody likes to talk about the holidays. So when, all right, how do I want to do this? The acronyms that I'm talking about. Okay, no. We're going to rewind a little bit more. So the point of posting, now remember, you don't want to be all spammy, spam, spam, and hey, buy one, get one free BOGO sale. Oh, hey, here's my Christmas deal, my Black Friday, my Cyber Monday, my 25% off this. You know, remember, people aren't coming to Facebook to shop. They will go to Amazon, eBay, Etsy, any one of those to shop. They go to social media because it's a social media platform. All right. So with that being said, let's not make your profile a sales page. You know, it shouldn't look like Target and it shouldn't look like Amazon. You know, they come social media, they're coming there for you, you know, and your awesome personality. Like, you watch my videos because I'm extremely funny and I have wonderful eyes and I'm probably the best looking guy on the internet. That's why you watch me. Oh, and I provide value. So doing it that way, and the whole reason to post is, yeah, make it entertaining. If you're a good TikTok dancer, fantastic. My TikTok videos are not you. I'm not a good dancer. Just gonna say that. I know. Sorry to disappoint you, but you know, you very rarely will see me doing some TikTok dance. All right. So it's the entertainment, you're providing value, or hints, tips, and tricks for whatever you find that you're passionate about. Maybe it's business. Maybe you like repairing bikes and riding bikes. You get where I'm going with this. So that's why people go on social media. All right. Now, for you as an online business owner, well, what does that have to do and how do you have that correlation to the business? Okay, we're getting there. We're getting there. The main reason to post is to get interaction, boost the algorithm, find like-minded people or people with similar interests that flock to your page to check out your posts. It's your job to entertain that and use the social media to have a conversation. When having a conversation, then you can, I highly recommend you slide it into the DM, all right? Slide it into the DM, and then you can ask about what their pain points are, because maybe they don't want to talk about their pain points on the profile in the comments, all right? You're more apt to get an answer in the DMs where people may be a little bit more transparent and off-guarded versus, well, I don't want to tell them that my aunt's in the hospital and I'm feeling pretty down and the weather has me bummed out, they're not probably going to tell you that on your main page. But in the DM, they probably will. At that point in time, now you can see if you have anything to ease their pain or provide value, or if you have a product or a service or opportunity that you can offer them that will help them out. All right. Now, so that's why we're posting. And as now here come the acronyms. These are cool. You might want to get a pen and be a writer downer. These are the notes I took for, this was day 3 in my sales and marketing training. Okay, so, and these acronyms weren't put in there in the training itself. It was more about the posting and the post ideas, and we'll get to that. But BES, BES, build, engage, sell. So you're building your audience. Okay, you're building your audience by putting up clever posts. You're engaging your audience by having conversations with them, whether it's on the main page where the post is, or if you slide into the DMs, engaging. Then, if you have the opportunity or you see that there's a need, want, or a pain point that you can fix, then you can sell to them. It's not sell, engage, and build. That's backwards. But mostly, that's what your company wants you to do. Just sell it. You know, spam the link. Oh, and then engage. And then build a relationship or a friendship or, you know, rapport. Build, engage, sell. BES. ILT plus D. Okay. ILT is invest, learn, teach. One of my good friends and mentors, Ray Higdon, he uses ILT. So that means you learn, or no, I is you're investing. You're investing your time, you're investing your money, you're investing your resources to learn something. So whether that's a course or a book or and maybe it was a podcast, maybe however you learn, you're investing in that, whether you had to pay for it or just took your time to learn it. Then what I'm doing literally right now is teach it to other people. So I'm, for this as a classic example, I invested my time and my money into this sales and marketing program. I'm learning it. Now I'm teaching it back to you. ILT. Oh, and then the D at the end of it, I just threw that in there because it's cool to invest your time and learn something. It's cool to teach it, but the D, the D stands for do. Then you gotta just do it, and that means taking action and doing the thing that you invested your time and learned, and you know, just do it now. All right, ILT plus the D. KLT, know, like, and trust factor. Know, like, and trust factor. That's how you're gonna be on, or that's how you get to the BES, you know, the build, engage, and sell. People are gonna be receptive to you because of the know, like, and trust factor, okay? Know, like, and trust. You know, if you're gonna go buy a brand new vehicle and you have a dealership that you've bought cars from before, or you know somebody that is a car salesman, you're gonna go there. You know, just hands down, you're gonna go there because you're familiar, you know them, you like them, and yeah, you trust them. Cool. And then the three F's. Feel, felt, found. So as a salesperson, you know, a good way to get your point across is with feel, felt, found, while explaining it into a story. And that doesn't have to take up a huge amount of time. It can literally be in like 3 to 5 sentences. So it would go like this. Before September 1st, and this is a real world example of me. Before September 1st of this year, I was feeling that I was overweight, out of shape, and when I brushed my teeth, my stomach would jiggle. I didn't like that. That's how I felt. So I was feeling a way. I felt that I needed a change. So I put myself, I started exercising again. I started eating right. I started actually exercising 2 times a day. Watched what I ate, drank a ton of water, and used my supplements, you know, my ketone supplements. I found that after a month and a half of, you know, eating clean, working out, drinking a lot of water, taking the supplements, getting the sleep, and being disciplined more in my health and wellness, I found that I dropped 27 pounds in 30 days. That's a true story. So I felt fat, gross, and disgusting. I found out I didn't want to do that anymore. Or I felt like, damn, man, there's just time for change. And this is what I found out after changing. So the three F's. So we have 1 + D and now we have 3 F's. The feel, felt, found. All right, let's get into what to post. Now, remember back I said, hey, it's the holiday season. Everybody likes talking about the holidays. You know, a question you could pose on social media, Facebook would be, well, I did this yesterday. Everybody knows about Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. What are the other reindeer's names? You know, I had to actually sing the song, Rudolph the Red, to come up with the other reindeers. What's your favorite food during the holidays? Do you have holiday traditions? Is this the same thing every single year? Are you gonna switch up your holiday traditions? So you can talk about the holiday traditions. You can talk and ask questions about the food, you know, because those are big points when it comes to the holiday seasons. Some people do the same thing every single year, and that's fine. You can ask them about travel. Are you staying in? Are you traveling? Are you flying? Do you drive? You know, are people coming to you? Are you the entertainer? That's another question that you could pose. Everybody has their favorite cookies. Ask them what their favorite holiday cookies are. Do they have to be gluten or dairy free? And how do you overcome those obstacles when it's the holiday season? Here's a good one to talk about. Lights, holiday lights. Do you hang them up inside? Do you hang them up outside? Did you put them away properly last year so that when you found them this year, they weren't all just mangled up in a big ball and you kind of got frustrated because you're like, screw this thing. Let's just go get new lights. Or maybe you plugged them in and that one little tricky bulb that goes out that makes the whole thing just stop. You know, holiday lights. They're either enjoyable or a major pain point for people. Ugly sweaters. Do you got, what's your ugliest sweater? That's a good one. Have you ever re-gifted a gift? And yeah, what was your favorite gift to Well, it was a favorite for you because you have evidently re-gifted it, so it wasn't a favorite, but you're like, hey, I'm super glad to just re-gift this. What was that item? Real or fake trees? What do you put at the top of the tree? Is it a star? Is it a snowman? Is it, what's your tree topper? What goes on the top of the tree? Holiday humor? Yeah. So by getting engagement on your posts with this, then you can go back on your post and start answering questions. So like if it's holiday travel, and if you're a travel agent, you know, and that's your business is travel. Oh, where are you going? And, you know, have you been there before? How long does it take? And then you can work in genuinely asking for information. Genuine. Just don't cut to the chase and get to the sell, because remember, we're building, engaging, then you can go for the sale. If it makes sense. Yeah, that's what I got for you. I'm super excited about this holiday season and what I have been learning in this sales and marketing class. That's cool. It's going on all of December. So ramping up into 2022 is going to be an excellent start. So I'm excited about that. I'm ready to slide into 2022 like Bo Luke off his charger. Whew. Slide on in. If you like this type of content, sales and marketing training, I highly recommend that you get at to me for some information about joining the Wednesday webinar, sales and marketing webinar. It's totally free. You know, it's on Zoom. You don't have to talk. All you do, type in the information, you know, your email address and all that kind of stuff, and get trained by world-class sales and marketers for free. You know, lasts about an hour. Why not? You're investing. Oh, let's go to this. You're investing your time. You're learning something. You're the L. And then you can shoot your own video like this and teach it to somebody else. So then you're ILT-ing it. Eh? How slick is that? So get at me and I'll definitely give you the link. And if you want to be on my email list, you know, I email blast people all the time about sales and marketing and cool stuff. All right. Take care. Thanks for watching. Make it an epic day.